Hey everyone, it's Kelly Rush, Technical Product Manager for Camtasia. Recently, I posted a tutorial about taking Camtasia 2022's included assets and making them even more engaging. However, in that video, I created a custom asset that I often use in my videos, an audio waveform visualizer, which is what you currently see playing on the screen. There were a few comments asking how to do this and if I could make a tutorial video. So that's what this is. Let's see how to do this using After Effects, Audiate, and Camtasia 2022. Speaking of Audiate and Camtasia, if you haven't checked them out yet, pause the video and give them a look. Both are available with a free trial from the TechSmith website. Check the description for a link. Okay, so as I said in the intro, we need a few tools to do this, and we're going to start our journey with Audiate, our new product for easy audio recording and editing. We're going to use Audiate to record the audio narration that we want to visualize in our video. Go ahead and press the record button, and after the countdown, begin recording your audio. Hey everyone! In this video, we're going to look at how you can generate an audio waveform and bring that into Camtasia to create your own customizable quick property asset. Let's get started. When you're done recording, click the stop button and your recording will finalize. You can use Audiate to improve the sound if you want, and when you're done, simply export your audio as a wave file. We'll keep ours simple and call it narration.wave. Okay, with our audio recording done, we're on to step two. We're going to use After Effects to generate the audio waveform visualization. Begin by importing the narration.wave file we just saved. Right-click it, and choose to create a new comp from the selection. Next, we need to add a new solid layer, which we'll use to generate the waveform visualization on. The default setting should work fine here. Once it's been added, apply an audio spectrum effect to it. For this effect, we need to select the narration.wave as the source. Once you do that, you can see your waveform, but just barely. We need to tweak some settings. First, set your side options to side A, so that we only generate the top half of the waveform. Next, we're going to adjust our start and endpoints. Without getting into too many of the details, we need to get our waveform pinned to the bottom of the video, stretching all the way from side to side. This will help when we bring it into Camtasia. There's still not much to look at here, and that's because the waveform is too short. We'll fix that by adjusting the maximum height setting. There, now it's starting to look like something. There's a lot of empty space at the right though, and that's because, by default, this effect uses a wide frequency. My voice tends to fall on the lower end of the frequency spectrum, so we'll reduce the end frequency. There, that fills things out a bit more. Let's drop the frequency bands down to 24, which is going to temporarily thin things out again. But that's okay, because we can fix that by increasing the thickness of the bands. The softness value ends up making them look quite blurry, so let's crush the softness to 0. We'll also change all the color values to white. We're trying to use this to pull a clean matte, so the fewer the colors, the better. Alright, now we're really rocking. I think the max height still needs to be cranked up, so let's just go ahead and max the setting out. Perfect. Okay, that's as far as we need to go with After Effects. Go ahead and throw that into the media encoder, render it out as an MP4 video file, and we'll head over to Camtasia. For the last part of this process, we'll begin by importing the video we just produced from After Effects into the Camtasia media bin, and adding it to the timeline. By the way, I added a background track here, just to make it easier to see as we build our asset. Let's take a look.
Hey everyone, in this video...
Okay, so far so good. Let's start by scaling down our waveform visualization to 50%. Next, crop the top half of the video by pressing the Alt key and dragging the control down. Once it's resized, let's move it back up to the center of the canvas. Finally, let's duplicate the media on the timeline by pressing Command-D on the Mac or Control-D on Windows. Okay, next, grab a rectangle callout from the Annotations tab and replace the bottom waveform clip. It's too tall, so just grab the control handle and drag it to match the waveform clip. Next, click on the Visual Effects tab and add the Remove a Color effect to the waveform clip. Nothing happens because it's trying to remove green by default. We want to remove black from the clip, so click the color dropdown, choose the eyedropper, and grab a black sample from the clip. Well, it removed it, but it's not much to look at yet. We can fix that. Grab the media mat visual effect and drop it on the waveform clip. Closer, but we still want a subtle background. We can get that by setting the media mat's mode to alpha invert. Next, let's change the opacity for the waveform clip to 20%. And finally, let's change the opacity for our white rectangle clip to 20% as well. Let's take a look.
Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to look at how you can generate an audio wave.
Excellent. You can play around with the opacity and dial it in however you like. Let's add a few final touches to bring this home. First, we'll add a frame by clicking on the Annotations tab and adding an empty rectangle to the canvas. Resize it so that it sits just at the edge of our semi-transparent rectangle. Next, let's add our text titling. Grab the text annotation, drop it in the center of the canvas, and resize it so that it lives just inside of our frame. You can also change the default text and any font settings at this time. By default, annotations are only 5 seconds in length, so let's drag them to match our other clips. Behaviors are a great way to make text titling more dynamic, so let's add a pop-up behavior to our text. We'll also turn off the during behavior, since it just distracts from our beautiful waveform visualization. Okay, let's go ahead and group everything, just to make things clean on the timeline. And to finish things off, let's add a glow transition to make a clean entrance and exit onto the screen. Perfect. And there you go. That's how you can create an audio waveform visualization to use in Camtasia. It's a pretty long process your first few times, but it's also pretty straightforward, and eventually you can move quickly through it. What do you think? Do you like this effect? Anything else you'd like to see? I'd love to hear it all. Leave me some thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe so that you don't miss other Camtasia, Audiate, and other TechSmith tutorials in the future. Thanks for watching.